Let's think about the question, why are the slopes of perpendicular lines? Why are the slopes negative reciprocals? And I thought we'd start thinking about this question by thinking about a windmill. So let's say that you had a windmill that looked like this. Like that, and like that, okay? So here's our windmill, and our windmill, we're looking at it, and the windmill is gonna turn like in that direction. So it's going to turn in the, I guess that would be the clockwise direction. Let's go ahead and put a sail on our windmill. So we're going to put a sail as follows. Like this, and a sail made of cloth. Okay, now this line is horizontal and that line is vertical. Now, as this arm turns, right, let's say this arm right here on the windmill turns 90 degrees. Well, because these two, this branch of the windmill and that branch, because this is a 90 degree angle right here, if this rotates 90 degrees, well, that sail on the windmill is then going to look like this. Like so. So what was first horizontal, that became vertical, and what was vertical became horizontal after it rotates 90 degrees. Now, if this length, let's say, was the length 3 and this was the length 2, right, then what would happen, of course, is that this length would then be 3 and this length would be 2 because it's been a 90 degree rotation as the wind caught the sail and caused the windmill to spin. Now, so a couple things we've assumed. We've assumed this is a 90 degree angle, okay, and we've assumed that this is horizontal and that's vertical. Now, of course, I began talking about a windmill, but imagine that that instead you were thinking about simply a line. So I'm turning these into lines. And if somebody asked you, what's the slope of that line? Well, you'd say rise over run. So the rise is 2 and the run is 3. And if somebody asked you, what's the slope of this line, you'd say the run is, well, negative 3, right? We dropped 3, and the rise is negative 3, we dropped 3, and the run is positive 2 to the right. So the slope is negative 3 over 2. And I can see when I compare these two numbers that these are exactly negative reciprocals. That is, you get this slope by taking the reciprocal of 2/3 and then taking the negative of that. Now, of course, I just used 2/3, but the same argument would hold true if m was equal to a over b. As soon as the wind caught the sails, the m of the resulting line is going to be negative b over a. Okay, and that's always going to be true for any two lines that are perpendicular. And that's why the slopes of perpendicular lines are negative reciprocals.